The views and opinions of this broadcast do not reflect the views and opinions of Armed Media, UNU Productions and its affiliates. Enjoy the show.
Welcome to All In, everybody. I'm Jim.
I'm Paul.
I'm Donald.
Dave dead?
Dave just left. He's having trouble with his computer.
Technical difficulties. And the missing in action, Jeremy Gibbs.
Yeah, so I guess it's us three tonight.
Yeah, where are you, Jeremy, man?
What was that saying you were just saying, Paul, or Jimmy, pal Mia?
Yeah, pal Mia.
Pal Mia.
Prisoner of war, missing in action.
Missing in action.
It's that my niece come home one day. She's 16 years old. What the hell is pal Mia? That's when they first come out with them, the black flags with the guy's face.
Yeah, right. It done in silhouette. Everyone knows that flag.
Right.
Dave is back in the room, you guys. Can we hear you now, Dave?
Yeah, what's up, guys?
We're live, Dave.
Hey, Jeremy,
what's going on, everybody?
Jeremy pulled the disappearing act.
Let me hand out the 1-800 number.
Oh, God.
It's 1-800-508-5431.
Thank you, Jimmy. I got that number memorized now, by the way.
Yeah, I got it, too.
Do we even know if it's coming here or not?
Did
Joe send it to us?
Probably not till 8 o'clock.
Yeah.
Fucking
A. You don't have the phone to call.
You mean to try to call you guys?
Before we start getting into the technical difficulties, this is how we deal with them.
We start getting into the meat of things tonight.
Right, that's what I was saying. See if the phones work.
Getting into the tank meat of things.
The tank meat of things, yes.
The new show, All You Can Eat. What's his name again?
Rob Rosenthal.
Rob, yeah. He had the same problems with the 1-800 number we did.
So. Yeah.
You could hear the frustration in his voice. It was great.
It hit the one and then it hit.
It's going to voicemail, you guys. I'm sorry, but it's going to.
We don't have a setup. He will at 8 o'clock.
You want me to text Joe? Do you guys want me to text Joe real quick?
Where did it go to?
It just went to voicemail.
Oh. Okay.
I can text Joe if you want me to, Jim.
Yeah, if you could text him, because I have no idea how to get a hold of him.
Shit at this point, really.
All right.
Do I really care?
No, not really, but I'll go ahead and text him anyway. Why?
Joe the he-she might call back.
That's right.
I wish you would.
Buddy.
Joe the he-she, if you're listening. Call back.
Please call back.
The one that got mad at Jim Bell.
But you got to wait like 10 minutes or so just so we can get the number switched over.
The number is 1-800-508-5431.
God, I hope nobody calls. Anyways.
All right. I just sent him the message, guys. I said, can you please send the 1-800 number to All In? We are live. So we'll see what happens. And that number is, one more time, 1-800-508-5431. Call in if you got something funny to say, or call in if you want to just cuss us out. I don't care.
Yeah, exactly.
I would prefer that.
I would prefer to get cussed. Yeah.
Me too. I would rather just be yelled at.
Yes, for talking profanity or just something somebody just don't like me, or Dave or Jimmy, Paul, I don't care, do you?
Yeah. Okay. Hey, I don't like me.
You're your own worst enemy.
He is. Oh, hey, we were talking about this off the air. I know it. After the show, me and Jimmy continued to have drinks last night, and I went home fucking annihilated, and I let my dog out, and then I passed out on the couch. And the dog was out for God knows how long. And my wife was pissed. And I mean pissed.
And the dog's pissed.
The dog's... He wouldn't even take food from me. He's been sideballing me all day. He's just looking at me out like out the corner of his eye. He won't even look me directly in the face.
You let your dog freeze, Paul. Shame on you.
Yeah, and he's a little dog, so it's not like a
big
dog.
It got cold last night. It was below 30.
I was annihilated. I had 10 beers and probably, seven or eight vodkas.
Where is our global warming at, Paul? Where is all this global warming?
Yeah, I know, especially in March. Yeah, What's going on here?
Did you see it snowed in Egypt?
Oh, really?
First time in 112 years.
Like I said, all it is a jet stream is moving.
They took a picture of the pyramids with snow on them.
Ever seen that?
It but, looked amazing.
That's pretty crazy.
Yeah, you guys, it is.
Dave Coop is right
like
now.
It's a jet stream moving. It's for the whole Earth.
86 where Dave's at, you guys. Must be nice, huh, you guys?
Say that again, Donald.
Where Dave is at right now in Texas, it's 86 degrees.
Yeah, must be nice. Yeah.
You must have the air conditioner on.
Oh, that sucks. I hate you. We got another foot and a half coming.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
Yeah, Tuesday.
You guys get it worse than we do, don't you? I mean, you're further
up
north.
It's been 40-something, the last couple of days at 33, enough to melt some, you know what I mean? I don't have 4 feet of snow on my roof anymore. It's about 3 feet now.
3 feet, oh, God. But it's coming. You're going to have 5 feet now.
Yeah, I know. Well, it gets scary.
You're going to get up there and put some of that off.
It's the ice, and it gets heavier when it's on the roof.
I got these kids that live next door. They're all young studs. I just send them up there. Fucking go shovel my roof.
Nah, I wouldn't let anybody up on the roof. You know what? These are trailers. So the roof is made out of 2x4. Not a 2x6, not a 2x8, 2x4s.
Well, what are you going to do, Jimmy, when you're laying there with a note on your chest that Paul leaves you the next day and all that smoke goes piling in on you?
Yeah, exactly. I'm not even insured.
Oh, Lord.
I got to get that.
Oh, God.
I got to re-up mine.
I don't have...
I don't even give a fuck about the trailer. It's everything inside.
It's not so much that. I got a tree right next to my trailer. A branch falls down, it's going right through. Say goodbye to my bedroom.
They're all getting taken out. All the dangerous trees are getting taken out.
Mine's right there, and it ain't getting taken out.
Jimmy, why is it you don't have insurance, by the way? I know I'm not trying to be nosy, but...
A lot of places won't insure a trailer.
Really?
Yeah.
I mean, right here where we live, we rent, but we have a thing called renter's insurance, and it's only like it's less than $20 a month, man.
They want like $100 for the trailer.
What?
$100 a month.
And that's more than I pay for my house.
Not for my trailer. They won't want that much. Mine's a 1965.
What? Mine's a 1983. I'm still up there.
Yeah, but isn't the cost of living a lot higher there? You guys was talking about one.
Well, not so much in New Hampshire, but Mass it is.
Yeah.
It's a little cheaper over the line.
It's definitely cheaper in Ohio than it is here still, though.
Oh, yeah.
New Hampshire's more expensive than Ohio.
Well, at least on the line. Up in New Hampshire might be cheaper.
Ohio's a very depressed state. Nothing personal, guys.
Oh, I get depressed here every day. I mean, Mr. Dave.
I was depressed living in Mass, so I know how you feel.
Well, I know Dave gets to get out of here every week. You know, he travels across the country every week, but I'm stuck here day in and day out, and it does get depressing.
Guys, I'm sitting down in Houston, Texas. It's about 78, 79 degrees right now.
Oh, that's nice. I like 78. Actually, I like 70-degree weather.
I've been to Texas. I liked it. I really like Texas.
That's what Dave said. He liked Texas, so it must be a good state.
Holy shit.
I like all these Gulfport states.
Yep.
The thunderstorms down there are awesome, huh, dude?
Yeah, Dave, you ever caught any tornadoes? You're in Tornado Alley, right?
Oh yeah, I've broke through a few of them.
Actually, I've never seen a tornado.
I've seen one. What about you, Paul? Do you see one from a distance?
On my motorcycle. I had a storm that was following me. It didn't look like a tornado, but I was doing 125. My bike trying to outrun the fucking thing.
So you used to ride a motorcycle, Jimmy, or do you still?
I came across from in California.
It's got a nice Harley.
And I came across when I left California. I came across to it died in Pennsylvania. I had to go back and get it. My back bumper was bumping up and down, rubbing against the wire, and it kept blowing fuses. It started out in the Mojave Desert. There's only one gas station. I pulled up to it, bought all his fuses. Because the thing just kept... I only brought three with me because in case something happened. I had a backpack full of shit, tools, everything to get this 69 fucking Yamaha across the country.
Jesus Christ.
And this was in 79.
Do you have a Harley now then, Jimmy, right now?
I got a Harley Sportster.
Did you have to mix gas for that, Jim?
No, for the other one, no.
Well, you and Dave had something in common, and you both ride Harleys. You don't have a Harley, don't you, Dave? Gooch?
He probably wouldn't have a sports, though.
I don't know. Well, Dave, what kind of Harley you got?
The only reason why I bought it is when I sat on it, both my feet were flat on the ground.
Yeah, it's low to the ground.
Otherwise, nice. I would have never bought the damn thing.
It is a nice bike.
Go ahead, Dave. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to cut you off.
What do you got, Jimmy? What is it?
A 1250 Sportster. It's a 2005. Last year they did the manual choke because I gotta keep forgetting to pull that fucking thing out. I don't know how many batteries I killed doing it.
What do you got, Dave? Can Dave hear me, you guys? Dave, can
I don't know.
I got a. I can hear you, Donald.
Okay. I didn't know.
I got a 2017 Ultra Limited Firefighters Edition.
Alright, what, Chevy Red?
Well, I want to ask you guys, you motorcycle riders, I want to ask you guys with Harleys a question. I think I already asked Dave this, but is it true that if you guys get women on your bikes, that kind of women enjoy that riding on the back of a bike because of the vibrations?
Oh, absolutely. Also, the bareback horseback riding, they love riding the bone.
I didn't know that one. I didn't know that.
Yeah, I knew that from little kids.
And the horse does, too.
The horse does.
Yeah, the horse did like the women better than the men, that's for sure.
Oh, I am not a horse fan. Not a fan of horses.
They're never been on one.
You've never been on a horse?
No.
Wow.
Well, Donald, you've never been horseback riding?
No, sir. I'd like to go, though. I mean, it sounds fun.
It is.
To me, though, the horse probably wouldn't like me. The horse would probably kick me off. Clydesdale, yes. Yeah, I'd probably have to get on a Clydesdale, and it'd probably buck me off.
Like fucking Mongo from fucking Blazing Saddles riding an ox.
Well, I'll tell you what. You guys remember the Brady Bunch episode where they took mules down into the Grand Canyon? I wouldn't do that for nothing. Nothing.
I'd do that.
You would?
Yeah, fuck
yeah. Yeah, I'd do that.
But if he was 300 and some pounds, you wouldn't, would you?
Well, I don't know.
Not on a little mule, no.
Yeah, they're strong as fuck, Jimmy.
They are.
Well, they always say strong as a mule, you know.
They could handle Donald's ample frame.
Ample. That's a nice way of saying fat ass, huh? Well, you guys remember last week when I was talking about women using urinals? Standing up pissing. Well, I did some research into this, you guys.
Did I tell you about I was standing next to a woman, she could pee further than me?
No, you didn't.
I don't know why I didn't get to make that connection. But anyways, I get out of the... We're all driving around. There's about seven of us in a car, and the girl got out. I just met her that night or whatever, but I know her from the neighborhood. Well, I get out, and I ripped my dick out and started pissing, and then she got... dropped her pants down to about her knees, and then she lifted the hood, and she could pee further than I could.
Oh, gee, well, Jimmy, my daughter...
So they can stand up and pee if they wanted to.
I looked into it, Jimmy. My daughter told me at the hospital this morning, my grandson got tubes in his ears, but my daughter said, I listened to your show last week, Dad, and it was kind of nasty talking about women, you know, having urinals in women's bathrooms. Then she told me about this device. They sell a device, you guys. It's called the Shee-Wee, and it's a little rubber thing a woman can put in her pants and carry around and piss just like a man.
Yeah, it's like a funnel.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Oh, I see. So they got like a fake dick and they whip it up to pee?
They just put it right over.
The end of it, though, it's like formed to fit around the hoo-hoo and your reach and all that.
The hoo-hoo.
The hood.
And they don't have to take their pants down.
Stuff off in the clitoris, the hole for her peeing.
No, it's not.
And if you order now, you get the slap chop absolutely free. Just pay shipping and handling.
Well, my wife looked them up. They're like $19. And I said, I think every woman should carry one of those. Because, I mean, look, when you go to those sporting events, a lot of times...
Right, now they can pee in a bottle.
Yeah, or just take a piss in the urinal. I mean, them porta potties are nasty, you guys. You guys know that.
But you know what, guys? That was sacred for a guy. That's the one thing we could do that women couldn't do.
Right.
We could piss standing up. They're taking that shit away from us.
Like I said, they could piss standing up if they wanted to.
In Scandinavia, right, they've taken, in the schools, they've taken all the urinals out of the bathrooms, and they forced the boys to sit and pee.
Are you serious?
Yeah, because it's a sign of male dominance.
Well, that sounds nuts, Paul.
Yep. That's an
toxic masculinity.
Yes. Yep.
Oh my
God.
That's
a new term lately.
I didn't want to go to politics, but I figured we were on the subject of it, so it was relevant.
But when you how do we get the politics from a piss tube though?
Why didn't we come up with something like that and become rich? Just think about that. The guy invented just like you said, just like a funnel. And so right. Stand there and just piss like a man. I mean, so simple, but I didn't think of it, you guys. It pisses me off.
Look at Ron Popeil. The guy fucking had more inventions. He had the pocket fisherman. He had the spray on hair. He had everything.
Is he a billionaire?
He was like a billionaire. You don't know who Ron Popeil is?
No. I've heard the name, but what's that one guy who used to advertise stuff and he died? I don't remember his name. He had a beard.
Yes.
I can't think of his name though. You guys,
for just $29.95.
Yeah, yes.
He had cocaine in his system,
and he always advertised that OxyClean and stuff like that. And
what was his name?
His buddy really missed him though. His partner. I mean, he like went. You know, there's Jeremy. Hey,
Willie Summer.
Jeremy's here.
Well, it looks like Jeremy's here.
He was on.
Where were you, brother?
I just got in from work.
Oh, okay. That's a legitimate excuse. We'll accept it this time only.
All right, I'm going to have to tell my boss to fuck off for now so I can get on the radio.
Yeah, because that's way more important than your job.
Yeah.
You went POW on us, Jeremy. MIA.
Well, it is way more important when his daughter is married to my cousin.
Yeah. That's probably off family.
He pisses off my family. He can't hunt on their land anymore.
Well, our shirts came out. One of our buddies got one of our All Aboard t-shirts, but I still haven't got mine yet. Because they didn't have 3Xs when we ordered them, you guys.
Yeah, I was thinking about we should do a shirt for All In, but I want to make sure if we do it, I want to get paid for it. I want to be paid for it. If you're going to use my image, I want to be paid for it. Okay.
I know where you're going with that.
I thought you meant who's going to pay for the shirts.
It's going to be me. That's a damn sure.
Dave timed out again. He must be in a bad location or something tonight.
I can't pay my fucking electric bill. Never mind a bunch of stupid t-shirts.
Well, this guy, he's making them. He's made them free for me, and they're on there if you just want to order them. I mean, I don't have no money in them. You know,
no, you could push them. I bet the hell everybody else does. Push them.
Plug it. Plug away. I didn't mean to say stupid.
Sarx, yeah.
I meant very attractive.
How did you remember that?
SAR X.
Rx Clothing, yes. They've got All Aboard t-shirts. It says Arm Radio Presents All Aboard. It's got a picture of me and Dave standing there next to a big old microphone bigger than we are.
Okay.
Then it gets our time. Thank you for the burp, Jimmy. I really appreciated that.
That wasn't Jimmy.
Thanks for the burp. Thanks for the burp. I like that.
Oh, thanks for the shard, then. He sharded.
Yeah. There you go.
That's a nice one.
I don't have anything to plug.
Me neither.
I wasn't really trying to plug our show, guys.
Okay, plug the show, Jim.
Let's plug our own shows. Yeah, you can listen to us on Pot Talk on Thursday nights at 8 p.m. Eastern. Me and Paul.
And Jeremy.
And then you can listen to my show, or me and Dave's show. Do your own, Donald.
Oh, you want me to plug my own? All right. You can listen to me and Dave's show on Tuesday nights at 8 p.m. Eastern Time. It's called All Aboard. And it, both of our shows are political, right, Jimmy?
Yeah, they got the same basic.
That's why we don't talk politics tonight. We got together and decided we're just going to talk bullshit.
Yeah, that's right. I was thinking politics. God.
Tonight is our fun night. We get away from politics, the serious stuff. And it's good to laugh. You guys, laughter's good for you.
It is. It's the best
good for the soul.
Yep. It is good for the soul, Dave. I think laughter is...
Laughter takes care of depression.
Yes. It does a lot for you, Jimmy. It even helps your blood and everything. You know what I mean?
Yeah, blood.
Your immune system.
Everything goes better with laughter.
That's right. That's why it feels so good.
Well, think about it, you guys. Our lifespan is short, very short. Why should we go around life all depressed?
Fall over laughing every day.
I used to all the time when I was a kid and hanging out with my buddies.
It happened once in a while and it'd be great. But like I said, I wish that would happen every day.
Or drop an acid.
What? Every look in the mirror, I fall over laughing.
Every time Donald stands on the scale, he does.
Oh, shit. No,
This is out! Get off!
I don't look in the mirror no more, you guys. I don't like looking in the mirror. I don't look like myself.
I can't look in the mirror either, guys. I got more chins than a Chinese phone book.
No, I got a beard, so I can't comb it. I gotta look in the mirror. Not that I like what I'm looking at.
I shaved mine off, Jimmy, because it was starting to look like yours. I shaved mine down.
I look in the mirror and I'm like,
that's a dicky dude.
I can't remember the last time
on.
I used a razor.
I'm like Fonzie when I stare in the mirror. I go to comb my hair and then I just go, hey.
He's got dicky dude going on.
Yeah, he got that dicky dude going on. His belly stick out further than his dicky dude.
Yes.
I call it
the last time he had a hot on, he had to take his wife's word for it.
Yeah. it's called Dunlap disease.
Shit, I thought mine was a pubic hair one day until I pissed out of it.
Yeah, a gray one.
Well,
I remember my first gray pubic hair.
I haven't got any of those yet, Jimmy. You said
I was like 18, 19. It was before my hair, before anything. It was a pubic
18,
hair.
19. Damn, you've been around a long time.
Yeah, did you pluck it? Did you pluck it, Jimmy?
He meant 1800s.
Yeah. I did. I plucked it. I got it in my head. Same thing. I'd start plucking them.
There's where you messed up, Jimmy, because they say once you start plucking gray hairs, more grow back. I don't know if it's true, but that's what I hear.
Well, of course the more are going to grow back, usually in the same spot.
Well, mine all fell out in my early 20s and nothing grew back. I mean, so.
That's right.
Just on the sides, and that pisses me off about being bald, because when you go bald, the sides still grow, and you look like Dumbo or whatever that clown is.
Bozo!
What the hell is that noise?
I don't know what that noise was.
That was me echoing. I echoed. I heard it in my earphone.
Was it you, Paul?
I echoed for a second. I don't know why.
But you guys, I don't know if you guys read about this, but these millennials, a lot of these millennials, they're not using these traditional engagement rings anymore. I don't know if you guys heard about it, but they're actually having diamonds embedded in their fingers now, you guys. I mean, it's
embedded?
Like a piercing.
Well, yeah, they're out of piercing. I mean, it started out tattoos to piercings to
have to hold on to something with all their might, and they realize now they got fucking stupid piercings in the way.
Well, you're right, and there was even people there. What do you call that? Scarring themselves, like burning themselves, putting scars on themselves.
Branding.
They're branding themselves now. Why the heck would you want to brand yourself?
Oh, my God. You would.
Because it's different. That's
you would have to get me there kicking and screaming.
When you're 16, 18, you come up with this dumb shit because it's different.
I don't have any tattoos. I don't have any piercings. Nothing.
I got
somebody pierced my ear, but it was the wrong ear.
You get the right one? You got your right ear pierced, didn't you?
Yes, I did.
You!
I was going out with the woman, her daughter pierced my ear. So, like I said, which you sure it's this one? Yeah, it's this side.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
So, did you freeze it first?
Yeah.
And did you use the potato at the back of it?
No, it was a gun.
Oh, oh yeah, you actually did it with a gun, huh? You went high tech?
High tech.
Yeah.
But I did. I remember freezing it.
I did it the poor boy way when I was younger, but I don't wear an earring.
What, stab a needle through it?
We froze it with a needle. I put a potato behind there. One of my friends actually stuck a hat pin through it, man.
Yeah, I did. I got my ear pierced. I never actually wore it. She did it with just a stud. She just rammed the stud right through. I took it out like 2 days later, never put it back.
Well, you guys, people are taking... my wife was even telling me about this the other day, a new fad for these younger people. They're taking their body parts off, like part of their nose and their ears, and they got a way where they clip them back on. I mean, I don't know what kids are thinking nowadays.
What do you mean?
Whoa, for sake.
How do you take a body part off and then click it back on?
Without it being rotten.
Yeah, wouldn't it just rot and fucking fester?
I don't know if it's fake or not, you guys, the part itself. But I should have sent you guys the link. But it shows this guy clipping his ear off these kids and the tips of their nose. And they got little clips and they clip the nose back on in their ear parts, you know?
It's like fucking Legos.
Dumb. Like I said, anything they can do that's different.
People are so desperate for attention.
Oh, my God. Not so much attention. It's camaraderie.
It's stupid.
With their age group. It determines them from other age groups.
What about the piercings in the eyeballs?
See, I express my individuality by not getting tattoos and stuff like that because everyone else has them.
Well, it's different now if you don't have them. You're different now if you don't have them. But it wasn't piercings, but people are not piercing, but they're tattooing their eyes, Jimmy and Paul, Dave.
Isn't that retarded?
I
got one tattoo on my shoulder. Girl stabbed me with a pen. She's got one in between her thighs because I stabbed her back.
What about the guys?
The big pens, you know, the old big pens.
Oh Lord!
How many assholes we got on this ship anyhow? Go!
That was an assault weapon, Jimmy.
I knew it. I'm surrounded by assholes.
You should have shot in that. I knew it. I'm surrounded by assholes.
You probably are tonight, Jimmy. Probably are. But have you seen the people who tattoo their eyeballs? Their eyeballs.
Nah.
What do they put on them?
And how do they see?
They can still see, but the whole white part of the eye gets changed.
No, he said the eye.
The eyeball itself?
They stick a needle in the eyeball and inject ink in there, and it covers the white part of the eye, and it looks freaky, man.
God.
Freak. Have you seen it, Dave?
Idiots.
No, I haven't seen that.
Oh, it's horrible, you guys. I'll send you some crap, Jimmy. Paul. You guys.
This I want to see. Absolutely. I thought you meant like the eyelids, like on the Three Stooges when Curly drew eyeballs on his eyelids, so he could sleep and look like he was awake.
I remember that. That was cool, man.
That was good photography. Oh, what do you want to call it? There, a good stunt.
They were truly innovative.
Yes, they were. You got to remember, this is back in the 30s and 40s. The craft's only been out for about 20 years.
You couldn't get away with shit back then, but somehow they figured a way to do it. Like when Larry would do the gay thing, oh, nay. And he would act like a gay guy, and they got away with it.
I'm going to send you a picture, Jimmy and Paul, and I'm going to show you this, okay?
Yeah.
I'm going to send it through Messenger here.
Better not be anything erotic, or I will definitely turn you into the police.
Go for it, man.
She's only 13.
Midget porn.
Yes. Okay, midget then porn. You can send that. That's cool. I'm cool with that.
Well, this guy's here. I just sent it to you, Paul. I didn't send it to Jimmy, but you can show Jimmy what I'm talking about. And in different colors. That's green. But it's weird.
What's green?
The guy's eyeballs, man. I mean, his whites of his eyes. It's weird.
Well, they're all hot spots across that.
What's that for, St. Patrick's Day?
Oh, he's also got tattoos.
Oh, that is fucking gross.
Scroll down, Jimmy, and there's all kinds of different colors, man.
I'm only getting the green.
Oh, are you? Yeah, it was only one picture.
Yeah, it's only one picture. Oh, wait a minute.
Is there
Hold on.
Oh, it's
crazy.
One person's even got one yellow eye and one blue eye. It's just crazy, man.
But I get the blue eye.
Yeah, but the white part, Jimmy, it's the white.
That can't be good for you. That can't be good for your
eyes. I got red, white, and blue eyes. I'm a patriotic eyeball.
Yes, yes.
Now, if I was going to do it, that's what I'd have. Red, white, and blue, and I would even like to bleed red, white, and blue blood, you guys.
Well, isn't that nice?
I would. I mean, if there's a way to dye my blood,
yeah. What is that noise? What's interfering?
I'm not hearing anything. Are you hearing anything?
I heard her fuzzing a little bit. I heard something fuzzing out just a little bit.
That'll happen.
You guys are hot micing.
Yeah, that's, I just hit it and got rid of it. Paul's busy on the phone.
Well, I was looking at the funny thing. Yeah, sorry. I mean,
we were quiet for a little while.
Yeah, when we go quiet for a certain amount of time, the mic starts surging.
Yeah, it starts surging.
Yeah, so that's what they were talking about. They was going to slap the mic, or Paul would say something to stop the mic from searching.
Like when I'm talking to my wife, it's like, yep, uh-huh, yep, okay.
Me with Val.
Good
boy.
Good I don't boy, even hear Jim. Her name again, man. I mean, she may be a nice woman, but my God, she just burnt me up that night, dude.
She's a hell of a cook. She sent me pictures of stuff she's made, and wow. It's like restaurant quality.
She should have sent you some food, though, man.
No. She sent pictures of food.
Mm.
Well, who sent you the cheesecake, Jimmy?
That was Maria.
Yes. Yeah.
Wait a minute, now, isn't that the one who goes live on her broadcast?
Right after you is what's the story with Maria.
Yeah, with Maria.
And she's got friends and stuff there most of the time.
Yes.
Yeah, she's got a good show.
Isn't she related to Joe?
It's his cousin.
Yeah.
Okay.
But it's not like Joe just puts all family on there.
No, it's
not. You know what I mean? He looks for people that are actually going to do a show.
Put it this way, he promotes her show more than mine and yours, that's for sure.
Well, it's a cousin. It's
yeah,
a,
I know.
A,
I, can,
cousin.
I can't
I don't blame
him
on that one.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Well, you got to take care of family. I mean, family does come first.
That's what family
guys.
Comes first.
That's right. Goddamn right.
Well, wait a minute now. Dave says, and it's true, God, country, family. But in this case, it's not, you know what I mean? It's radio, so yes, family first.
Family, country, God, that's me.
Oh. Not a good time for the crickets, I don't think.
It's family, country, reefer.
Yeah, that's yeah. God's yeah. getting further and further down.
Yeah. Well,
actually, it's reefer, and then what were the rest of them again?
Alcohol.
Reefer, alcohol. Family.
Yeah.
You got a shitload of them then, right?
I got a lot of priorities. I just can't remember.
Yeah, none of them are the right ones, but they're priorities.
What was it? Vodka? Didn't you say you drink a lot of vodka? Was that what
Which,
you
were yeah. drinking vodka
right now?
God, I don't know how you guys do that, man. I'd be sicker than a dog, man.
My liver loves it.
I've Your been liver. Drinking vodka since a teenager. I started out at 15 with whiskey, then went to vodka.
I used to drink Seagram 7. 7 and 7.
I used to do highballs.
But it's what the fuck is a highball?
Whiskey and 7 Up or ginger ale.
That's a 7 and 7.
Well, that's a highball.
Oh, I didn't know that. So yeah. I was drinking highballs
all
that time.
The time.
You guys are all highballs.
7 and 7.
What about a Boilermaker? Ain't that just a shot of whiskey down in a cup of beer?
Yep.
No, you throw it inside the beer.
You drop the shot in the beer.
In the mug, and then you drink the whole thing at once.
Dude, that sounds like it gets you really drunk. But you know the thing about you guys? If you ever stop drinking, that's probably when you would get cirrhosis of the liver, when you stop drinking.
It kills a lot of people.
When they stop?
When they stop drinking. If they're raging alcoholics, that's how Garcia from the Grateful Dead died.
Gary Garcia, yes.
Gary Garcia, he went into detox.
Oh.
And he died from alcohol withdrawal.
Hey, you guys, they say detox and alcohol is one of the worst detox ever.
I don't think so.
I see. I was drinking what is it? A 1.75 liter in my fridge.
Yeah.
I was drinking one of them a night, and when I went into jail about 2 weeks later, all I could do was smell a beer in my cell. I was ripping my fucking cell apart because I could smell it so strongly.
So you are hooked.
I was hooked, but I didn't drink beer. That's what got me. But I smelled beer and wanted one.
Huh, that's weird.
Yeah, because you're craving alcohol.
I was craving alcohol. Exactly. And the first thing I drank was beer when I was a kid, 10 years old. I used to put it in shot glasses because I hated the taste, and I'd force them down.
I do too.
I did a 60-day bid about, I don't know, about 7-8 years ago. And the last thing I thought about was a drink. I wanted a cigarette and an iced coffee.
Not to hassle on the past shows, but when I before I found out I had cancer, for some reason, you guys, I never craved whiskey in my life, and I got a craving for whiskey, and I was drinking tequila, Jack Daniels. I was downing it by the fist, and I didn't even know I was sick, and didn't know why I had this craving. My body was wanting something; it was telling me something.
Absolutely.
I never had a craving, so tell me why I craved alcohol when I had cancer before I found out about it.
Maybe it was the chemo that did it.
It's before
you even knew. Oh,
yeah, wow. I mean, it was Christmas time, and everybody's asking me what I wanted for Christmas, and I was telling everybody to buy me fists of Jack or tequila. And I was downing them, you guys, and it wasn't making me drunk. I don't know what the problem was. It was, like, weird, man.
I can't drink no tequila.
Well, tequila and me are not friends.
See, I can if you do the lime and the salt.
You mean the lemon?
Lemon, no, it was lime.
Was it lime? It was lime and salt.
Nah, not me. If I drink straight tequila, I'm going to fight a wall somewhere.
I wouldn't drink it straight.
Wall's challenging you, Dave.
It was very nasty.
I'm going to eat way too much food. I'm going to fucking throw my guts off, and I'm going to lay in bed the whole next day going, what the fuck happened?
Do you guys get like that off in different liquors? I mean, so vodka don't do you that way, right?
Well, because I mix it. I'm not drinking shots of it.
A couple shots, I'd be sick, Paul. Two shots of anything. 80 proof, I'd be sick tomorrow.
I can metabolize anything.
Well, your liver's anything. Used to it. Your liver's used to it. Your body's used to it.
And I had a physical about a year ago, and they said my liver was in very good shape. Especially so if somebody that drank with me, like me.
You don't have a hard liver then.
Not fatty or whatever they said it was. Fatty liver.
Dave and Jeremy's been awful quiet tonight. I want to hear from them. Dave, what's been going on? Tell us something funny that's went on in Texas or anything, brother.
Absolutely fucking nothing. I got screwed in Texas.
I was
trying to get kissed.
There's a country gone in there. Yeah.
You got bent over, and you didn't even get the common decency. They didn't have the common decency to give you a reach around, did they?
They didn't even give me a reach around. That's right.
One time, my cousin and I touched wieners.
When your 10-gallon hat is feeling 5 gallons flat.
Hey,
guys, that's about it right now, guys.
Are you pissed off tonight, Dave? I mean, you just don't seem like your chipper self.
Dude, it's been a 13-and-a-half-hour day, and only got one local load done. Then I go to drop a trailer at the tank wash to get it cleaned out, and they say, oh, we can't have it done till 9 o'clock in the morning. So now I'm here till then or till they get another one clean.
Do we have a goat update?
Yes.
The goat, the goat's getting fat. The goat's growing. It's almost time to throw flip-flop. It's almost time to make lamb chops out of flip-flop.
Yes.
Hey, I love chops. It when you guys hit that
mic.
I
want pitches.
We're going to put it on the grill.
Yeah, I want to see what kind of meat you're going to get.
I have a feeling we're going to be seeing Dave's obituary in the newspaper pretty soon.
Them and cook them in rotisserie.
Who's talking at once? I can't hear either of his.
Can't hear us?
No, because we're both talking at the same time. I was getting it bolting one ear.
Oh, I'm sorry. I was asking my wife if she had any pictures of flip-flop.
She hasn't come over and seen him yet, I don't think.
No, I thought Dana put some on the online, though. I don't remember.
Oh, man, are you kidding me? It was like the giraffe thing. It was like a video, and people were watching it, you know, waiting for it to be born, and then pictures of it being born. I'm just thinking, like, I just got to feed that thing, you know. I'm ready to cut it now.
Are you being serious? And Jimmy's hitting his mic because that stops that humming noise, you guys.
It ain't stopping it. You still hot micing, Jim.
Yeah, I know we are.
No, we're going to always be a hot mic. I got it on.
We got
voice.
No way to.
I got it on continuous transmission.
And if we go to push the talk, it blows. So I'd rather have the fucking humming.
You see how. When you guys are talking, it don't do that.
There you, Jimmy!
Like I said, if we keep talking, we do it. But when we don't talk, right. I got to
so
stop tapping
in a while,
the
I'm
mic.
I'm just going to have to go, uh-huh. Yep. I'll just agree with you, so what?
Hey, that'll sound like when Donald was talking with Val.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
Uh-huh. I'm going to have to write a song about that night. I'm going to have to write a song about that. The night I met Val. Uh-huh. That's what I'll call it.
It'd be longer than Inga Dada. Uh-huh.
And she has no idea what you're talking about because she never listens to our shows.
No.
She probably doesn't. I mean, I listen to your guys' show and everybody else's, but no, I don't listen to her, you guys, because she made me feel like I was stupid, man.
She's done that with a lot of us.
Yeah, she's taking a shot at all of us. But I personally like Val.
She's the mostly educated out of all of us, but she's making minimum wage. All right, so who's the smart one?
There you go. There you go, brother.
Her husband makes good money.
He's working for the electric company, shutting people off.
Now, what is she like a life coach, you guys? What does she do for? I mean, what is her show's about? Just telling people how to act toward herself or what? I mean,
I think her shtick is she's like the same thing with the sex doctors and all that. I think she's some kind of psychologist, psychiatrist.
Well, she talks
not
about
psychiatry,
a lot of
but psychology.
She talks about all sorts of different stuff. She's
didn't
not subject driven.
Didn't you say
well,
she
when she
about
first
a
came on, it was sexual driven. Yeah. She used to describe how you would give a good blowjob.
Really?
Oh, yes. Lord.
But that's and that very, would get that's a good before my there. Time.
Yeah.
Before Jimmy's time. What is it now? Somebody said something about teacups. Who was talking about teacups?
Did a show on, it was like a tea service. She went on.
She sent me the link, so I can look at these teacups. I'm saying, you're shitting me.
And then she's talking about cucumber sandwiches and stuff like that. And me and Jimmy kept trying to change the subject because she had us on the show. And you know, not for nothing, I understand she was interested in it. Not the greatest radio. So me and Jimmy kept trying to change the subject, and she was getting mad at us for trying to change the subject.
Wow, man. I don't know. How do you guys... Jimmy, I feel sorry for you guys. Listen to everybody's show, though. I mean...
She's a nice person, don't get me wrong.
I like to say I listen to everybody's shows, but a lot of them I just put on Fox News, and as soon as they start talking, I turn them down. I listen to Fox News.
I set the hour
timer, so a couple of minutes before it's time for them to shut up, I wake myself up.
Well, you also have the shows, right, that are supposed to go on the air.
Yeah,
they never show up.
So I'm playing music for an hour, waiting for them to show up. I stopped that shit.
Yeah, you shouldn't do that, Jimmy. I mean, if they don't show up at the proper time, I don't think you should be on there, man, because they made a commitment to you and Joe to do that show at that certain time, you know?
Exactly.
That's right. Jimmy's sitting here taking his time out to help these people put on a show. And if you can't show up for it, then you don't belong on the air.
I think it's going to be two strikes and you're out if you don't show up without a good reason. You know what I mean? At least call you guys.
Well, shit, I'm late every Friday. I'm off here before you know it.
He's got two. That's your last one. Three strikes, you're out.
Two strikes.
You got to let us know.
I mean, does that only sound fair, though? I mean, because...
Well, I sent Paul a message, but he didn't...
You sent
Paul? Anything back,
oh, he
so.
Did? Paul, I didn't see it.
I
checked.
Just
saw
trying
checked.
To see
I
if
looked.
You did, and I didn't get one.
If I have that on Messenger, I deserve that.
I tried to call you, Jeremy, and it wouldn't go through.
That's because my phone was shut off until about 15 minutes ago.
Oh, I thought you rolled me. I thought you hit the FU button on me, man.
No, not on you, Donald.
All right. Well, anyway, I got a question for you guys. I might have sent Dave this article. You guys want to hear about this story that I read? I know Dave.
Somebody got a washing machine or dryer going in the background or something.
No, that's Jimmy and Paul's mic.
Yeah, because we're not
smacking.
Sorry, I'm not going to go looking for anything.
It's fine. It's not bothering me, you guys. It's not bothering me. I mean, but you guys want to hear this story about this 46-year-old woman in Oklahoma? It's a very short story. Sure. Well, anyway, she's a 46-year-old woman in Oklahoma. She married her 26-year-old daughter, you guys. And before that, she was married to her son. Now same-sex marriages. Yeah, she married her daughter here recently. And before that, she was married to her 26-year-old or her son. Well, same-sex marriage is allowed in the state of Oklahoma, but incest is not.
Yes.
So she can serve. She's facing up 10 years in prison for incest. 10 years for marrying her daughter.
Good. She deserves it.
Then she was married to her son. I mean, what kind of wacko is this, man?
Oh, just imagine family reunions there.
You know, there ain't a whole lot of branches on that family tree.
Yeah, it looks like fucking Caliglia.
I didn't write her name down, you guys, because I didn't even want to mention this lady's name. I think it's
sick. No, please mention her name. Don't.
No, she's just, it's just nasty. I read that story and I was like, what the heck? I mean, 46-year-old woman marrying her daughter after getting divorced from her son and having sex with her
children? You did say it was Oklahoma, right?
Oklahoma, yes.
Okay.
Right. Close enough to Mormon country.
Whatever.
Well, same-sex marriage, like I said, is allowed in Oklahoma, but incest isn't, you know? So.
But that was the whole point of same-sex marriage, was to open up the fucking floodgates to everything. Now I can marry my daughter, I can have fucking marry a fucking 9-year-old.
I can marry anything.
Goat? Dave, a goat?
Right.
Well, that's not me, that's the cow head.
Hey, you're not going to kill my wife, are you?
Yeah. It's a shotgun running in a capsule in your face.
Jimmy says it's going to be his wife.
I can see it now. Papaw's going to marry a Shetland pony.
Only because it's the right size.
Yeah. Well, you got to think about things. Are you compatible?
Right. Do I have to stand up in a chair to fuck it, or can I just come up and bind and fuck it?
Just fuck it.
Well, goat, you had probably get on your knees, Jimmy.
I'm not sure. I'd have to get my knees if I wanted to blow me.
You're sick. Why don't you just grab it and put it in your lap?
Can you even get a blowjob from a goat, or is it just going to grow?
I would. Maybe a baby goat without the teeth.
You ever see what they do to a
They have a lot of teeth.
They come out with no teeth.
Just knock its teeth out.
Do they have teeth when they're born, Dave?
No, they don't.
I don't know. I didn't stick my finger in his damn mouth.
No, the same with cows. They don't have
a We weren't talking about fingers.
Now, I wouldn't ask that question, but now Timmy's talking about getting blowjobs from goats, so I just wondered if they had teeth when they were born.
I don't know.
They suckle when they're born. They don't chew.
Oh,
you
God. You dick and something like that and a fucking animal's mouth that can fucking chew a tin can up and fucking digest it.
Right, yeah. No teeth.
No, but I'm saying eventually it's going to get old.
That's a coke addict's delight.
What are you going to do, give it hormone shots?
No, but that's going to yeah, keep gnawing on it. As long as there's no teeth, you keep chewing.
Oh,
and then
God.
Once the teeth come in, you kill it. And eat it.
Yeah, that's when flip-flop gets shot.
That's when flip-flop gets shot, yep.
Yep. What's the teeth come in?
I don't know if she's had any more messages from
goat humpers,
by the goat or not.
Hey, if Jimmy ever gets your goat pregnant, Dave, then I don't think you should eat it. Yeah, you should just give it to him.
If Jimmy gets my goat pregnant, we're going to have a shotgun wedding.
Oh, my God. If Jimmy got a goat pregnant, the fucking offspring would be precious.
Paul,
see it? It'd be a goat body with a Jimmy head.
He's got the beard. A billy goat beard? Do you know a goat
beard?
So, he just sits in front of the computer all day watching Fox.
Jimmy is a trip, man. He's a trip, man.
Fucking great. It's blown with gray hair.
Yeah, that's funny. That's epic. It is epic. You know, Jimmy even started talking about it's epic. I mean, here's Dave with a baby goat. Here's Jimmy talking about if they give blowjobs. I don't
think that. And the best part is he's very matter-of-fact about it. It's not like hypothetical to him.
He don't care.
Well, talking about getting a blowjob from a goat, yeah.
Like I said, when I saw a black guy getting it from a calf, I see you gotta be shitting me.
Did it get you thinking, Timmy? Did it get you thinking?
No, I wouldn't have done it.
No, it got him hard.
But it did get me to thinking, yeah, they come out sucking. You know what I mean? And it only would a black guy think is stuck in his dick in its mouth.
Oh, God.
I don't know. There's probably plenty of people in Appalachia that probably yeah.
Hey, 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 hey,
listening to this show.
That's easy Cooch's, now.
That's Cooch's brothers and sisters down there and family yeah. and cousins.
And if I offended anyone in Appalachia that is currently getting a blowjob from a calf, I am sorry.
Or their sister.
Or their sister. Yeah,
right. Yeah. Or their mother or whatever. Saying.
That just offended everyone in Appalachia.
Well, I didn't mean it. Well, you
yeah, you did.
No, I didn't. No, I didn't, man. But you guys, let's think about something. We're humans, right? But we're really just animals. We're mammals, right? Mammals.
Bestiality.
Hey, now, hey, guys. Now, look at this. Think about this, though. If you have two grown women staying in the same house, what normally happens within several months? Their periods regulate when they go at the same time.
Yes, they synchronize.
Do they really? They synchronize. You know why they do that? So you can breed them both at once.
I didn't know that.
Oh, okay.
Is that a true
story?
Did
you ever see that?
Yeah, they do. They period synchronize.
They did an episode of that on Married with Children. Really? They go up to a cabin. Yes. And the name of the show was called A Period Piece. And Al and Marcy, you know, they all go up there. And Peg and Marcy and Kelly all start getting their period at the same time. And all the fucking animals and stuff start coming around the cabin because they can smell it.
I remember that now, yes. But I didn't think they were synchronizing their periods. I didn't realize that, you guys.
No, they do.
If women yes, live together, they get synchronized with each other.
Well, can I ask my wife that, you guys? I mean, does she
know? Oh, God, Donald.
If women are getting together long enough, two women.
I tell you, I don't get no respect.
Does their period synchronize after a while? He said some women do, you guys, so I guess he knows about that.
See?
Well, she should. She's a woman.
I am a man.
Go to the source.
I get eight sisters, and I don't know that.
Well, if you got eight sisters, Jimmy, you should know that. They should all be going at the same time, right, as you was growing up.
The youngest sister is 2 years older than me, and then keep going every 2 years, and it goes up the line. Like I said, I got eight of them. I never talked much about sex.
They're probably out of that now. I mean, they probably, when a woman get a certain age and she stops bleeding.
Well, every one of them is beyond the, what do you call it there, going through the change of life. Yeah, they're all beyond that.
Change of life.
I'm what, 61? Then youngest girl is 63.
Hey, you guys, my wife just gave me an update about a pregnant woman. She said if a man is around a pregnant woman long enough, that the man can pick up her cravings. You know how women get these weird cravings?
Yes.
Well, yeah,
I did do that for 8 months with the girl. Jesus Christ. I had a kid.
I get them cravings every night at 3 o'clock in the morning when I'm shit-faced. You see the stuff I make.
Is that when your wife was pregnant, though, Paul?
My wife was never pregnant when I was
but you just got cravings anyway.
Yeah, because I'm a drunk.
I can't believe
it's munchies.
Not cravings. Munchies, yes, you got the munchies. But yes. What I was talking about, though, you guys, is we're animals, right? Mammals. We're considered mammals. When in the hell, or why in the hell, did women start feeding human babies animal milk? Why don't they just breastfeed them like other animals? Why did we start feeding our babies animal milk? Don't you think that's what's wrong maybe with these
kids? Well, the only animal milk was cow.
Right.
Oh, you're talking about goat milk, too.
I mean, any kind of milk, but why does a human being... I can understand some women that breastfeed. I mean, some women still do breastfeed. But they say, women feed their babies cow milk, goat milk, or whatever. I mean, we're getting animal in us. You know?
Yeah.
Why did they start breastfeeding? I mean, not breastfeeding, but why did they start using animal milk to feed human babies? I don't get it, man. I mean,
since the beginning, that's how they figured out, you know, hey.
Well, a lot of women couldn't breastfeed.
And I still drink milk. And I think I'm a little above breastfeeding age.
My thing is, who was the person that seen that cow drinking the milk and be like, that might be good if we drink it?
Right.
They tried it warm, and I guess it tastes better warm than cold.
Ugh. Warm milk is gross.
No, I thought it was pretty good.
All right. We drink cow milk, right? Would you drink a woman milk from a woman?
No.
If they buy
it, I've tried that. It?
No.
From a pregnant girl,
squeeze
in the nipple in my face.
Donald, you ain't never you've had kids. You never.
No, David.
Snuggled up to your wife. Took a drink.
No, I didn't.
That's what they call leaking.
I don't even think I was breastfed.
No.
Well, I'll tell you, some women can squirt that stuff across the room, their breast milk, but I just don't know why they feed animal milk to babies. Why don't they feed them their own milk from the mother? I don't get it, guys.
My mother was 44 Ds.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Woo. Was she breastfed, Timmy? Was she breastfed as a kid?
She breastfed everybody.
Infamil. Oh,
my mother breastfed none of us.
So, Jimmy was breastfed.
Like I said, your mom ever tell you?
I don't know. I never asked her. I'm sure I was. I don't know.
Yeah, I wasn't breastfed. Maybe we're messed up when we're not breastfed.
And she said, no, that's what fucking hippies do. Yes, I absolutely did. And she said, no, that's what hippies do.
No, if you're breastfed, it's better off than the Similac or whatever. You're definitely better off breastfeeding.
Yes, they say you're healthier.
Yes.
You're a lot healthier. I'm healthy.
You're lucky. Thank you, Jimmy.
That's where I was getting at. It is healthier for the baby to be breastfed instead of being fed animal milk. And sorry I took so long on this subject, but wanted to get that out there. I don't understand it. I guess it's easier, maybe. I don't know. Than them flopping your titties out and feeding your baby. I don't know.
Well, some women's breast milk doesn't have enough nutrition to sustain the baby.
Well, are you right?
That happens if you're vegetarian or vegan. You can't breastfeed your kid because there's not enough nutrition in it.
Well, I can understand those women, okay? I can. I do understand certain cases. But wouldn't it even be cheaper for people just to feed their baby from their own body? These women?
Yeah. Some people don't want to keep clinging from their fucking teat. You know what I mean?
Well, that's right. I don't know. Times have just changed. Back in the old days, when did you think they started this stuff? I mean, feeding their baby cow milk. I mean, how long has this been going on?
I don't know.
I was born in 65. My brother was born in 63, my oldest brother. And my mother didn't breastfeed any of us, ever.
But they had Similac back then. I can't remember if it came out in the 50s or the 60s. It was like the greatest and the best. You could get more vitamins and everything a child needed from Similac than you could from a woman herself.
Right, but
turned out to be bullshit.
Well, do you know what it is? It's they don't have the enzymes in the for digestion and shit to get the kid's digestion system.
They couldn't absorb it.
Yes, exactly. It is better.
So out of all of us.
I do want to take a commercial break here, Donald.
Donald, we got to take commercials.
Okay, go ahead, brother.
We'll be back.
Go ahead, brother.
Nice shooting. Hey, that's a
AK-47 chest. Not yet.
Yeah, got it from StrikeHardGear.com.
Strike what?
StrikeHardGear.com.
Set your sights on StrikeHardGear.com. Tough, tactical gear for your Soviet-style weapon that's made in the USA. Affordable, plus a no-questions-asked 30-day money-back guarantee and lifetime replacement warranty. StrikeHardGear.com. Go ahead. Pull the trigger.
Everyone, you got the 215L. Doesn't matter what kind of sandwich, sir. I'll explain later. Thank you, sir.
Jimmy John's.
Come in. Sir, did you know your house is on fire?
Yes, I did. Grab a bucket.
Jimmy John's.
Come in.
Sir, did you know your house is on fire?
Grab a bucket.
Jimmy John's.
Come in.
Sir, did you know...
Yes, I did. Grab a bucket.
Jimmy John's. Come in. Sir, did you...
Yes, I did. Grab a bucket.
Fire department.
Come in.
Sir, did you know your...
It's okay, Captain. We got it handled. Care for a sandwich?
Thanks, but tell me something.
Shoot.
Why didn't you call the fire department first?
I did.
Jimmy John's, America's favorite sandwich delivery.
Hey everyone, I want to tell you all about an amazing salon, Joyce's, located at 132 Ferry Street in Everett, Massachusetts. Joyce's specializes in the latest techniques in coloring, styling, cutting, and beach waves. Joyce's features Sukesha all-natural nutrient products and organic color. Joyce's full-service spa and salon located at 132 Ferry Street, Everett, Massachusetts. 617-387-6680. Specializing in you.
Welcome back, everybody.
Hello, everybody.
I gotta go to the men's
room. This is All In with Jim. This is a show All In, our second hour. Jim Bell, Paul Daniels, Dave Coots, and Jeremy Gibbs. And this is the part, usually it starts getting dirtier. And Paul, I'll start giving the number out since Jimmy.
I was gonna say, you gotta give the number out.
Yeah, the number, if anybody wants to call in, I guess it's the hour you can call in. It's now 8 o'clock Eastern Time. The number is 1-800-508-5431. At least try to call in. I don't know if it's turned on or not, but call in and have some fun with us. You know, talk to us, cuss us out, whatever you like, just call in.
Yeah, just and cuss us out.
This is the show tonight. Point. Cuss us out, yeah. Thank you, Paul. Yes, I like to be cussed out.
Yeah, I don't want people agreeing with me or saying, "Oh, great show" or something. Just fucking give me shit. That's what I need tonight.
Call me a bald-headed fat ass. I don't give a crap, man.
Bald-headed fat
you
ass.
Fat, bloated.
Bald-headed fat ass.
Bald-headed toothless fat ass. I don't care.
Oh, that's right. I forgot.
Well, I'll tell you right now, if they call me that, I'm gonna punch them in the face.
Dave, how you gonna punch him through here, Dave? Dave will be streak tracking him down, man.
Like Roger Waters said, the toothless are ruthless.
Well, everybody's got teeth on here except for me. So I got, I'm the only ruthless one in here.
No, I got a couple missing in the back.
Is Jimmy done yet? Or he's got like a gallon of bladder? I don't know.
He's plugging back in now.
I'm in. What are we talking about? Back teeth? Because the only one I got a wisdom.
Yes, what is it? I need to go pooping!
Well, he said something
no, I
about
didn't take a piss, but thanks for asking anyways.
Paul said if you're toothless, you're ruthless. So I guess me and you're both toothless and Jimmy. I got 5 teeth left.
Woo!
We can pull those for you, Donald.
Yeah.
No, Dave, I'm not letting you pull my teeth.
I believe I've got over 10 left.
I got all but 2.
I've got
I'm missing a lot of my backs. If I didn't have wisdom teeth, I wouldn't have any back teeth.
Well, we're going to have to wait for you to get back from Texas to do that.
I'll be back Sunday night.
Maybe I don't even like it when it happens.
We can record it.
I was going to say, it would be great. Go live on Facebook.
Don't give him no ideals. Don't give him no ideals, Paul.
No. We're talking creatively here.
But all if right. he goes on live on Facebook, it would just be him.
No. When he gets back from Texas,
I get to use
he
Novocaine.
Can pull Donald's teeth with a pair of pliers live on Facebook.
Oh, yeah, he can do that.
If he's got Novocaine. If he's
got some
Novocaine.
Lidocaine.
No, I got some crystal meth.
They're gonna finish you.
Hey Donald, we could always do the thinking man and knock you out, then you could wake up.
There you go.
That would work, but that makes me sick though.
Like on that, the three stooges with
punch.
The balance.
The truth serum.
Fuck that thinking man. Shit, that hurts.
Jeremy and Donald both have felt the thinking man.
Yeah, that hurts.
It's a punch, you guys. It's you're just sitting there and you just whack.
That's
out
when I become Bobo instead of Jerry.
It made me sick, you guys.
Can I ask you a question?
Jeremy's alter ego comes up.
Yes,
Bobo.
Yes, Jimmy. I'm afraid, but yes, yes, I'm afraid. But go ahead and ask.
Do any of the 14 that are left got cavities?
He's got 5, Jimmy.
Yeah, I do, and I've got 5.
You got fillings?
What happened, Jimmy, is...
So what?
No, I'm not messing with you. I'm
see, that's
really
why I'm losing all my teeth now
one at
because
a time.
I got fillings in the 80s, and they fell out. My teeth cracked. And now I'm just waiting to pull them.
Well, did you do that to yourself, though, on your teeth?
Hey, Dave, you plan on being in the
weight room? I mean, you know what I mean.
I blame it on crystal meth. That's why I lost in my... A lot of my back teeth was crystal
meth. I think Jimmy
meth.
Needs a visit from Dr. David Coots.
That's right, Jimmy. You need some teeth.
I got two of them going to come out. They're only half teeth.
Dr. Dave makes host calls.
Anything I do is cold or hot. Fries or not.
On air.
Anesthesia.
Wow. All Paul's got to do is call you. Paul's got to call you and just say he's out. Dave, come on over. I mean, when Jimmy passed out, just ride on over Dave, Jimmy's and pull his teeth, man.
Yeah. Jimmy, wake up with no teeth. Paul, make sure you leave him a note. Pulled your teeth.
I'll play the dental hygienist. Just sit here, Mr. DeBell.
I was going to say, how come I can't hear
you? But you need suction. You got to, Jimmy, you can't hear us?
No, I was I didn't have my ear plug in.
Yeah,
right.
He's like, why can't I hear anyone? Because his fucking ear
plug is
Hey, that was a whole different meaning to you got a pretty mouth, boy.
Yeah, and Paul can sit there and use a vacuum cleaner for suction.
Yeah, a short vac.
Shout back or something. You just suck his whole mouth out. You know what I mean? What, Dave's pulling his teeth out?
Fucking pancreas.
The radiation did mine, Jimmy.
My asshole.
Oh, shit.
Just turns him inside out.
Jimmy's probably got teeth in his anus, though, man.
Well, I got a donut that's hot as teeth.
A donut?
Yeah. Oh, you're talking about a hemorrhoid then, right?
Hemorrhoids.
Oh,
yeah.
You do?
You're talking about hemorrhoid?
I've never seen them all my life.
Really?
Yeah.
I've never had a hemorrhoid in my life.
I got them from drinking vodka and grapefruit. It'll make your ass fucking pucker.
Pucker?
Oh, yeah. That's what that was all from. And now it's a hot donut.
Put
you
some alum on
shit drawing.
Your asshole looks like it's saying ooh all the time.
Well, if I can't get a shit through it, I don't shit that day. I gotta wait a couple of days until it just can squeeze itself through.
Until it becomes
You need to bend over and let Paul ream that out for you with a rod.
No thanks.
Yes. Wow.
You can
damn.
Push it back in. You can push the hemorrhoids.
The
back
only thing that's been up my ass is my finger and my wife's
Oh,
finger.
Jesus Christ, this is not a good show for Facebook Live, that's for sure.
Call him squad.
Hey, your wife and son's going to be moving in with you soon, aren't they?
Oh, that's right,
yes.
Jimmy. Do we have an update?
No, I haven't.
When's the last time?
Yeah, he did send me. He spoke in front of the class for a book report or whatever it was. She sent me that.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah, it was pretty cool.
She obviously has listened to our show then.
Did she say her dad was a radio show host? I gave her the information.
Does she know you're a host?
I doubt if she ever went and listened.
She probably listened once and never did again.
Yeah,
like
exactly. Like everybody else.
Well, I mean, does she know you're a producer for a radio show, Jimmy?
Yeah, she knows.
Yes, Jimmy is important.
I've been doing it for 5 years, and he's been around for 6. So, yeah, she knows.
Well, I mean, said he did a class project, or she did, or whoever. I mean,
he was doing the book report or something. He had a piece of paper in front of him that he was reading from. Basically, I got to learn, you know, he's 6 years old, and he's reading pretty good.
What was the report on, Jimmy?
I don't know.
Yeah, good thing you paid attention.
Yeah, I know.
I
really
couldn't
understand
the word. I thought I was here, right here.
Well, I mean,
hey,
some people
Paul,
do report.
Just leave him a sticky note. He'll get better.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, you got to remember, I heard it when I was drunk.
Oh, what were the odds on that?
So I really don't remember what he said.
Hey, man. Paul, Jimmy, were you guys live? Do you guys get Amber Alerts on your smartphone?
Yes, we do.
Yep.
Unfortunately.
I'm responsible for seven out of ten. Oh, gosh, Paul. Sandusky, Ohio. A girl's just been abducted, so just let everybody know out there.
Yeah, but who? By a father?
Yeah, I just got that same alert.
They never give you the full fucking story, and that's why I don't bother with them.
Oh, here we go.
You know, that pisses me off with them, especially when the father takes him because the mother's so unreasonable that you have no choice but to act
you know,
wrong.
Why isn't a father allowed to take his own children? It's gotten downright
exactly.
stupid in this country. I mean, I'm with you, brother, on that.
As far as that concerned, you're a indentured servant. You don't deserve visiting rights. Just keep paying the money.
Do you know why fathers never get custody of their children? Because they can afford to pay for them themselves. So they don't need the government to raise their children.
Right. A woman does, though.
So, and she'll go on the dole. And if that's
The man gets screwed.
Misogynist or sexist.
Hey, guys, I'm going to tell you right now, the government don't care about the kid.
No.
They don't.
What was that?
They say they do, but they don't.
It's not about you.
I wouldn't let my mother blame me, but I'm not about to let the government blame me.
Go ahead, Dave.
What was it, Dave? Dave?
Hold on.
Something must be happening. I wanted to hear what you said. I don't know what you were saying there. I was something about the... I know Jimmy don't want to be played.
Yeah. Well,
he made... Oh, there
he made that really obvious.
Are you having technical difficulties, Dave, again?
I was. I think we're good now.
Yeah,
what were you saying about the kids and the money?
I'm saying they don't...
You disappeared again.
It's about money, putting it in an account, drawing interest, and then charging poundage on it. When I finished my child support for all my kids, the last $1,500, they didn't even get. It went for administration fees.
Yeah,
they make money off of it.
They make you an indentured servant.
It's sort of, it's about jobs. It's about government fucking jobs.
This is what Britain did when they sent their prisoners over. You're an indentured servant. And they made this country. They started Boston. They started Jamestown.
I thought they left for religion.
Well, that's why we rebelled and said we're not going to take it, right?
That's Plymouth Rock.
Did you just plug your show there,
fathers, that is.
Donald?
No, I'm just saying our founding fathers.
No,
we're not going to take it.
I don't give a shit.
We're not talking with them.
Seriously, Paul, you're killing me, Paul. Anyway, I've got a really good joke. You guys might have heard this joke, but it's a classic, you guys. It's all called Hurricane Jesse. Have you ever heard it?
Not sure.
Paul and Jimmy, you guys are older guys. This is an older joke. You guys might have heard it. Well, anyway, there's this guy. He went to a whorehouse. So he had like $90 with him. And he asked the lady there. Thanks, Jimmy. He asked the lady there at the front counter. He says, I got $90. What do you got? And she said, well, you're lucky. We got a special day on Hurricane Jesse. He says, I don't know what that is, but I'll take it. So they sent him to room 99. He goes in. He dozes off to sleep. So he wakes up, and this naked lady straddled over him, and she's blowing in his face. He says, lady, what the hell are you doing? And she says, I'm Hurricane Jesse. That's them warm tropical winds coming in with the hurricane. So she leaves the room. He falls back asleep, wakes back up. She's straddled over him again, beating her titties in his face. He goes, lady, what the hell are you doing now? She says, I'm Hurricane Jesse. That's them coconuts falling off the trees due to the winds. So he dozes back off to sleep, wakes back up a few minutes later. She's straddled over his face, pissing in his face. He goes, lady, what the hell are you doing now? She says, I'm Hurricane Jesse. That's them warm tropical winds coming in with the hurricane. So he's getting out of bed. He's got one leg in his pants. She says, where are you going? Are you leaving? He says, I don't know, lady, but I sure as hell can't fuck in this kind of weather. So, I don't know.
That's not bad.
It's
not bad. It went in a totally different
direction. I didn't think it was gonna
heard it before. I like that one. Send that to me. I'm going to use
an old one. I was concentrating on smacking the mic, but yeah. I got the gist of it.
Thank you.
That was like in the
Sixth
Sense.
I appreciate that.
And you find out that Bruce Willis is dead, and you didn't know it. It went in a totally different direction.
Yeah, it did.
Well, but you're like, who can fuck in this kind of weather? I mean, she was Hurricane Jesse. She was a whore. That was her thing, you know, being a hurricane. So, I got
a. You don't pay a prostitute for sex. You pay her to leave.
Yeah,
right. To leave. That's right. True. But
which hospital is this? I feel a flu coming on.
What? Huh? What do you mean?
What's it? Never mind.
Nobody got that.
Yeah, nobody got the joke. I wanted to go to that hospital.
Which hospital is this? I got a flu coming on.
Thank you.
Did you get it, Dave? Did you get it, Dave? I didn't. Paul, I mean, what does it mean? Tell me, please.
Never mind. Move
what
on.
Hospital?
No,
is, I got
no.
A flu
if on. I have to explain it, I don't. It's not funny. Just move on.
Well, I didn't know it was a joke. I'm sorry, man.
Don't be sorry.
This is the second hour. We only get better. You got another topic?
Evidently not.
I got another.
This hour.
I got another whorehouse joke. I have another whorehouse joke, you guys.
Okay.
It's not. You guys want to hear it?
You got a thing for whorehouses, Donald.
Well, we were talking about it last week. Remember talking about whorehouses? They should be legal.
Yes.
This guy goes to the whorehouse. All right, this guy goes into a whorehouse, and this guy's only got $25. He was a poor guy. He says, "I got $25. What you got?" He said, "Well, we got a one-eyed Betty up there." And he said, "I don't know what that means, but I'll take it. You know, that's all I got is $25. So he goes up to a room, and this lady comes in wearing an eye patch. She pulls the eye patch off. She's missing an eye. And she goes, "Go ahead, get me right there in the eye socket." And he goes, I don't know about that. So he goes ahead. He says, "Well, I done spent my $25. So he starts getting her in the eye socket. And so he's enjoying it. He had a great time. He said, "Man, that was awesome." See, he said, "I'm going to be back around another couple months. Will you be around?" And she yells at him as he's leaving. She said, "I'll keep an eye out for you, honey." I could go on and on, but jokes get old.
Nothing like a good old-fashioned skull fuck.
Fuck, yeah.
Yeah, skull, yeah, you've heard that, yeah. I'll poke your eyes out and skull fuck you or rip your head off. And you guys heard that, so.
Yeah, that was shit on your neck thing.
Oh, yeah, I'll rip your head off and shit right down your neck, yes. I love them old things, man. Nobody says that anymore.
I'll rip off your head and shit down your neck.
Yeah, that was Army, but what movie?
Oh, Full Metal Jacket.
Full Metal Jacket, yeah.
Oh, he's great. I love that guy.
he's an actual drill sergeant.
Yeah, he's badass. He's no badass.
Yeah, he is.
That fucking guy. I want him at a party. I just want him at a party.
I want
just
him on the
yell
show.
At everyone.
I want him on this show.
Oh my
guys.
God. If Joe, if you are listening, you have connections, get him on here.
Yes.
Please.
Especially on this show. This show. he would be giving us hell right now, you guys.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. He'd be calling your fucking little militia group a bunch of fucking faggots.
What do you think, Dave?
Girls wear skirts?
Yeah. When you're out there, what are you doing wearing skirts? You little faggot! Driving coots!
Oh, God. Oh, God, he just called Coots a faggot.
I smack him in his fucking mouth.
Oh, now it's on. It's on.
Come at me, bro.
You gotta admit, that guy's funny, man. That guy
is funny.
Yes.
Just so y'all know, this is streaming live on Facebook.
Oh, Jesus. Thank you. My life is over. Thanks.
I found a way to do it without the echo.
Yeah.
I'm going to send you another picture, Paul, if you don't mind.
Quit sending him porn, Donald.
I'm not sending him porn. This one is a good picture. This is a good picture of a man that I consider my brother, Dave Coots. I'm going to send Paul Daniels a picture of what Dave looked like when he was 18 years old.
Doesn't look like fucking...
Do you know what I'm going to do is I'm going to blow the picture up.
This is military.
Print it. I'm going to put it on my bedroom wall.
I'd rather have Stormy Daniels.
This is military.
Me too. To each his own, Jimmy. To each his own.
I'd prefer a poster. It would be Stormy Daniels.
Yep. You're going right next to my Farrah Fawcett poster.
Thanks, you guys. Stormy Daniels is going to be one of my main topics. Well, not my main topic Tuesday night, but I'm going to get to her.
He's plugging our show again.
No,
shameless.
No,
all aboard 8 o'clock Tuesday night.
Shameless.
What's the subject?
Series.
Stormy Daniels.
Jimmy, who makes the shirts?
Cyrex. SAL capital X.
Well, Dave, it's gone. I can't find it. It won't let me go back far enough. Facebook Messenger's messed up here.
No wonder why Les left the show. He's sick of the fucking merchandise.
I really need my
image on that shirt there, boys.
Hey, I'll send you a picture, Paul. This is a guy who bought one of our shirts. He calls in our show every week. His name's Chris Fifthwater, and I'll send that to you, Paul. I can't find Dave's shirt for his picture.
We gotta do a shirt with all of us.
Yeah, we do.
We should. Yeah. The guy will make them for
me. I want to get paid if I'm going to be on the show.
Oh, God, you guys. Dave, they were doing this before you came on tonight, Dave. Paul was, by the way.
Yeah, but let me tell you something. I just don't think God. You can quite do it like I can.
Oh, God.
We gotta get drunk and do the list.
No, you guys are making fun of
him. He was on this show. He knows it's all in.
It right? Is. I forgot. This show is all in. It's about fun. Isn't it?
That's we love it. We'll poke fun of him.
If we could have two people that sounded just like Les, we could do dueling Lesses.
I haven't even tried doing them because
let's hear you, Jimmy. Let's hear you do it.
Let's hear you, Jimmy.
I don't even know where to start.
Jimmy, don't do impersonations.
I like to talk to you guys.
Oh God, you guys are killing me now.
You know, every one of you guys are going to go. You guys know
he's listening. You guys know Les is listening.
We're going poke fun.
Well, it is all in. It is all in. That's what it's about.
Since how many assholes we got on this ship anyhow?
Hey, you know what? Hey, guys. You know what? It is all in good fun, but Les does have a new show coming up, unscheduled.
Exactly. Plug them.
Wednesday night, 7 o'clock. Everybody listen.
Who does? The 28th.
He just plugged Les's show.
All right, it's 2 weeks.
Yeah, you know, we're giving him a hard time. We got to plug his show.
It's unscheduled.
Les is a good sport. I guarantee he's laughing. And if he isn't, I'm sure his wife is.
Paul, I sent you two pictures. One of them is Dave.
You sent him more porn again.
Yes. He can look at Dave later on tonight.
Let me check these out.
Now, what
does Dave turn you on?
One of them is with our shirt.
See?
Nice and clean shaved.
Dave said he's more weathered now, is what he told me. He said, my face is more weathered now that I've gotten older.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
That was an 18-year-old Dave.
Does that mean leatherized?
There he is wearing the shirt.
I heard a phone.
Oh, shit. I gotta block this right now.
That's Les.
No, it's my buddy Tim calling.
Oh, I thought you was getting a call in 1-800 number.
I'm going to kill
you. We're being hacked by him.
Yeah.
1-800-548-5431.
I think he got thrown into Facebook jail, and he's fucking put up a new account.
No! Hey, I had to do that. And
yeah, I know.
They found the new account, and they took it, too.
I posted one of your pictures, Dave, and I shit you not. 15 minutes later, I was Facebook banned.
Yeah, you and Jeremy have spent more time in Facebook jail than fucking what's-his-face there.
That was my first time ever in Facebook jail.
Here's the thing. I wasn't in jail. They put my account under review. Pending permanent expulsion.
Well, look what they post stuff about like Muslims.
Pending permanent expulsion.
Yeah, they're literally talking about, well, like, if you do one more bad thing, we're barring you from Facebook.
Well, you should see some of the memes he spreads, you guys. Dave's got, a lot of...
They're not going to be as arrogant when somebody else starts another Facebook.
Hey, there's one...
Well, that's okay. I'm actually doing that as we speak. So.
Yes, it will come out. It is conservative. It is a conservative-based Facebook. I forget the name of
Infinity it. Infinity SN.
They're putting millions into this thing.
Good.
Well, really?
I'll join it.
Facebook is trying to stop them right now, though, Dave. They've done everything they can to stop them from opening up Infinity.
I would be a little concerned with Infinity SN security.
Well, the thing is, Facebook is biased.
Opposing points of view.
They're very biased, you guys, Facebook is.
Of course they are. So isn't YouTube. So isn't fucking Google.
The whole internet's biased, I think, you guys.
Well,
those
big ones, they're all libtards.
Do you have a fucking... what is it? The Amazon fucking dot.
Echo? No.
Yeah.
No.
Ask it what Muhammad is, right?
Yeah, we've done that
what's
before.
The name yeah, of okay, yeah. Jesus is a fictional character.
Alyssa, what's her name?
Alexa.
Yeah. Oh, Google yeah, that's
Jesus is a mythological
character.
Yeah.
Yeah, but it'll tell you what Muhammad is, you know, and in reality, he was a goat-humping, rapist, pedophile piece of garbage, but that's just my opinion.
Which one, Muhammad or
Yeah, and he
Jesus?
Suffered from dementia.
Not just your opinion.
He was butts.
He perverted that religion. When he made the trek to Mecca, you know, that whole religion went bye-bye.
Yeah, do you ever notice that Islam and Judaism have a lot in common, like their dietary regulations?
Same Bible until they get to a certain point.
Because he was trying to make it more palpable for fucking not people that knew Judaism or Christianity.
Christianity wasn't out then.
Yeah, it was.
Christianity
was long before it.
Oh, yeah. Islam's
only been around since the 6th century.
No, they've been around longer than Christ.
No.
Wrong,
wait a minute.
Wrong,
Jeremy, Google
wrong.
It. Jeremy, Google it, please.
Wrong.
Well, if you watch the miniseries, The Bible, Islam was actually directly created where Abraham sent his mistress and her son out into the desert. Basically alone, and I think that's kind of where Islam came from.
Yeah, it's from like the 600s.
See, if Les here, Les could tell us all about that, you guys. I mean,
Jesus himself had not been born to the earth.
Is this one of the newest religions ever?
Yeah, it's out of the big three, it's the newest.
Well, can I ask you guys a question?
Judaism, Christianity, Islam.
Well, I got a question, and it's for Jimmy. What's wrong with
Islam
you guys?
Came around in about the 7th century.
Not to get political, but when our founding fathers wrote the Constitution, do you think they had the Muslim religion in mind when they wrote that Constitution?
Absolutely not.
No!
Me neither, well, guys. Thank you.
Islam well,
our, if you remember, though, our founding fathers, when we were actually fighting Muslim pirates when our country was new.
Yes.
Yeah, our founding fathers saw Islam as a threat.
Yes.
Yes, because
Thomas
we were
Jefferson
fighting. We were
specifically said it.
Yeah, we were fighting Muslim pirates with ships coming over from England.
Yes.
I didn't know that. So what was the whole religion thing put in the Constitution for? Was it just about like being a Baptist or the different Methodists and any
Catholic? No,
it was to guarantee we could practice the religion of our choice without being stopped by the government or anyone else.
But here's the thing:
as long as
the
religion did not countermand the Constitution.
Exactly.
Right.
Islam is in direct conflict. Sharia is in direct conflict with our Constitution.
Yes.
That's what I was trying to get out. It doesn't go along with our way of life, Sharia law. Right.
Our founding fathers never anticipated Islam to be as big as it is. They never anticipated that kind of religion to be in our country.
Exactly.
It is in direct conflict. Sharia law, their whole belief of Sharia is in direct conflict of our Constitution.
Yes, and they did mention in many of the letters that the Founding Fathers had written that they believed that Islam was a direct threat to a constitutional republic.
Yeah, there you go. I love that word, republic. This is a republic, guys. It is. Not a democracy.
At the time, we were dealing with Muslim pirates.
We're talking politics again.
I know, but do you know what the word republic means?
Yeah, Republican.
No.
No.
the word republic means a thing of the people.
Yes.
Yeah.
Democracy mean?
Democracy is...
It's about
the means
more ownership.
Of preserving the republic.
Do you know the difference in a constitutional republic and a democracy?
No, I don't.
In a democracy, the majority rules. So if you have a bicycle and three people want your bicycle, they can take it. In a constitutional republic, you have rights to your property. You have individual
rights. Right. Yeah, okay. Yes. Now I know what you mean.
Property, liberty. I've got a segment coming up on that one day. You guys, a big segment we're going to do one day. Now I'm plugging my show.
There he goes,
Does it ever end?
Yes, it is. Jesus, I'll tell you when, Christ. Right now. I didn't get around much, you guys, to go to these fancy restaurants when I was younger. But when I turned like 19, 20, somebody took me to Chi-Chi's. I don't know if you guys have ever heard of Chi-Chi's, right?
No.
Yeah.
Well, anyway, they had one of these, now I know what they are, they're handicapped bathrooms. But when the first time I ever went into a handicapped bathroom, I sat down, and those bars are on each side of the toilet. I said, man, these fancy places, they even put grunt bars. I thought they were grunt bars, you guys. So I put each end on these bars to take a nap. And I said, man, this is nice. And I came out and told the whole table I was with. I said, hey, man, I'd like to get me some grunt bars for the house. And they said, what are you talking about? And I said, that bathroom in there, they got parts you can grab the grunt with. And they said, that's for handicaps. So, you guys, I'm telling you, I haven't been out much these big, nice places. So, I really thought they were grunt bars, not for handicap.
Grab bars or grunt bars?
Grunt bars. For you know, when you take a crap, you grunt. You know? So, I grabbed the bars.
That's why you got a hemorrhoid. If you got to do that, there's something wrong with your poop hole there, brother.
Does anybody grunt when they take a crap on this show but me?
Grunt?
Grunt.
When it's splitting my donut, I scream.
That's funny, Jimmy. I knew you was going to come back with that one. In the same way with the margarita, you guys, they asked me, they said, how would you like your margarita? On the rocks? And I was like, no, I don't want no rocks in my drink. I just take a regular old margarita. And Linda says, that means crushed ice or ice. And I said, well, hell, why did you say ice?
And poor Linda's thinking, Jesus, I married this.
Well, that's because they're talking like Frank Sinatra with the
fucking
rocks.
Fucking magnum.
Poor Linda, we feel for you. We really do.
I've never been to places like that where they ask you, would you like that on the rocks? I mean, on the rocks? I'm like,
Linda,
no.
If you're listening, we're sorry.
Yep.
Bless your heart. Bless your heart.
Our heart goes out to you. Trust us.
He's probably sorry, you guys. I've embarrassed her quite a few times. I've embarrassed my wife outside. I have.
Big surprise there.
Yeah.
Right.
I like the word big.
But you know what? She's still with you, Donald. So that says she loves you the way you are.
Yes.
I'm loved the way I am. I love that. Yep. Yes.
She loves you just the way you are with the
that's
fucking
right.
Bolting and neck and all.
Ain't there a song
I am.
The one I feel for the most is Dana. That poor woman with the craziest son of a bitch I've ever met.
Hey.
Well, what about Paul? He's married.
That's a compliment, Dave.
Yeah, but I don't have kids.
Well, that's true. You don't have kids, but they grow up and leave the nest, and you're
remember. I'm a thinking
he
man.
Doesn't have kids yet. Yeah, no. He's still 50.
What do you say? I don't have kids yet. I'm 50 fucking 2 years old.
Right. I got mine at 55.
Well, your swimmers aren't dead, there, buddy.
Yeah, Jimmy. I learned
your swimmers aren't dead.
Mistakes.
Yeah, well, I know you're not going to go to Craigslist, but something could happen. Losing a condom.
My wife had a fucking hysterectomy. If she gets pregnant,
might not be
somebody's in real trouble.
You could go flirt around.
Your life's not over, you know.
Now Jimmy's getting me in trouble here.
Stormy Daniels, Paul.
I hope your wife ain't listening to the show.
Oh, she probably is.
I am a bad influence.
Let's find his wife and tell her to listen.
I think I'm friends with her on Facebook, Paul.
Yeah, but the good thing is, right, if it was Stormy Daniels, I'd just say, we're family. We're hanging out.
Yeah, like she's gonna believe that.
Yeah, exactly.
Like she's gonna believe that.
Just because she's gorgeous and good looking and I love the fuck, it doesn't mean I will.
And her last name isn't really Daniels.
It's Danielle.
He's just another dumb.
If Trump didn't
just
do it,
another
dumb
bitch that wants a 15-minute of fame. That's all Stormy Daniels is.
I don't care who you are. You can't blame the president. That was 12 years ago. Who cares?
Right. I could give a shit who he fucked 12 years ago.
Yeah.
Oh, shit. Why would he worry now? He's got a hot wife.
Well, they're showing it now. She was a lot hotter than what she is now. Now she got fake tits. Well, what he paid her, she got fake tits. because they're just balloons.
Nice.
I don't like them.
You don't like the big ones? No, fake ones are not. No, they're not that good.
No, they
are. Well, when they got none, they're better than none.
Boobies. I heard anything more than
boobies. I didn't like her boobies, what was shown.
Because, oh, I'm sure
she got them new.
Yeah, Jimmy, she's going to fucking unfriend you on Facebook?
Who?
Stormy Daniels, because
I don't have Stormy Daniels as a friend.
Daniels?
Hey, have you guys ever heard that saying, you know, a mouthful of titty and just enough ass to keep your balls off the sheet?
Well, there you go.
Yeah.
Well, what about, I've always heard that more than a mouthful is a waste. I mean,
I like small tits, small, perky tits.
I've never had
that's
a woman like that.
That's what I like.
I've never had
anything more than a mouthful is a waste.
Then why were you, when you were on Craigslist, why didn't you punch that in instead of come in mouth?
Because I wanted to come in mouth.
Well, no, he didn't know what that meant.
Before I wanted a tit. You can't fuck little tits.
Oh, God.
Anything more than a mouthful is a waste.
No,
it is.
No,
it is. I like small tits because they're so fucking perky.
No.
I don't want to. You drop the
anything less than a mouthful isn't worth messing with.
Yeah. Anything less than a mouthful will get you fucking jail time.
Yes.
No, that's what I'm saying. Get nothing to do with age. There's a lot of brass and small
tits. Really, Jamie? No. That's the one I get it for? I've done way worse jokes than that.
Hey.
How many assholes we got on this ship anyhow?
What about Joe Walsh?
You.
Joe Walsh made a song about I Like Big Tits. Remember him?
Big tits. I cannot lie. Your other brothers can't deny.
No, Joe Walsh. Yeah. Not that guy.
Was that Sir Shake-a-Lot? Sir Mix-a-Lot, yeah.
I like big tits when I'm doing coke because then you just fucking fill it with Vaseline and just go wild on it for fucking 13 hours. You're cold in the face.
Jimmy promoting cocaine.
Yeah, Jimmy.
It was a big part of my life.
Show constantly. You're coke.
That's why we got to leave you sticky notes now.
Yeah,
sticky fingers. That's a part of my life too.
Yeah,
Jimmy, you're gonna pick up sponsors from cartels down in Mexico, brother.
I hope not.
Instead of lube, he uses Vicks VapoRub.
Yeah,
he likes the smell.
Yeah, get rid of the smell of shit when you're fucking him from behind. Yeah.
You get anal and it lives in nostrils at the same time.
Exactly. I never liked anal on a woman nor a man, which I never did, but why would you want to smell shit?
Oh, my God.
It's just an instant turn on, droop. Talk about...
First of all, why did you even mention dudes?
Well, because I remember existed for $1 million when he was
shit and get it up.
Well, trust me, I'm on the same side with you.
All right, well, that's what
except
I'm talking about.
Except you went to the dude thing.
Well, like I said, broad or man, it doesn't matter. They smell like shit.
Well, yeah,
you know
shit
what I mean?
Is shit.
Oh,
the balls smell different than the crotch.
Oh, Lord.
All right, but the assholes smell the same.
Hey, Jimmy, what about the taint meat in the middle?
Yes, the taint. What about the taint, Jimmy?
What
taint?
Come on, Jimmy. Taint
the
meat.
Taste
taint.
Of it.
What taint? About the taint meat in the middle?
Yeah, taint its asshole. Taint its balls.
There's taint in the crotch, but I don't see it in the asshole. It all smells like shit, no matter what asshole it comes from.
Oh, God.
You know, the only difference is the food you ate.
Jeremy, sound effect.
Oh, God. Jimmy, man, that's epic, dude. That's epic right there, brother.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is. Jimmy, it's well, you both are naturally funny, and I'm just not naturally funny like you guys. I mean,
no, you're not.
Your life stories are funny.
Especially
Jimmy's.
Jimmy's come up with some good ones.
No, Jimmy, but your life stories are really funny, man, the way you say it. I mean, you're just naturally funny, man.
Well, that's because I'm constantly ADHD, and I get bored.
No,
order for me to get over my boredom, I start entertaining.
Do you know what it is? Jimmy's a fucking completely open book.
He is
not.
Right, I tell the truth and nothing's secret.
Yeah. And if you don't like it, piss on you.
You know what, Dave? We respect that out of Jimmy and Paul, don't they? Because they're both. And Jeremy, you gotta admit, Jimmy and Paul will tell you straight out. That's what I like about them. They don't hold nothing back. They'll just tell you.
I try to hold back, and I blew a load anyway.
Yeah. You can't. I can't. That's how I am. You know, there's no sense in it.
Well, that's what you've been trying to teach me, Dave, is to be myself from now on.
Jimmy, sometimes less is more. And by less, I mean less.
Yeah.
Less guy, Mom.
Less, if you're out there, call in. I don't even know if the number's working, you guys. We got 15 minutes left or more. You mean try to call the number again?
Yeah, call it.
Just see if it's working.
We got 18 minutes.
Hey, all right. Dave, do the phone number as less.
Oh, Jesus. Oh, God. What is it? What's 508? What?
1-800-508-5431.
Everybody, we need you to call 1-800-508.
Hey,
what's the rest of it?
5431. We're the fucking drunks.
Hey, you guys. Oh, my God. It's still going to the answer machine, you guys. It didn't get
it
over.
It is hard to keep control of 10 numbers, you know what I mean? When your brain only accepts 7.
I don't know. It's going to the answer machine, Jimmy. I don't know what happened tonight.
Big fucking shock, huh?
I wish we could have got some callers.
Who's in control of that?
I want Joe the he-she to call back.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter anyways, because when they call, we never get the fucking call.
Well, he won't call back because he insists he wasn't a he-she. Joe, that's not a he-she. Call back.
Call back. Well, he can't now.
Very nice, Jim.
He's in control of the phones anyway.
800-508-5431.
You do know the call's not coming to us, Jim.
Yeah, it's going to... I just called it.
It's going to fucking voicemail.
It's going to voicemail still? Yeah.
Yes, Jimmy. Can you do something about it?
I'm going to try calling Joe.
Yeah, for what? The last fucking 3 minutes or whatever?
Hey, we got 15 minutes left.
Oh, fuck.
Call him up, Jimmy. Call him up. Let's get some calls.
Yeah, I mean, get a hold of him.
Don't tell him how many people tried to call him.
Put it on speaker.
Oh, ain't nobody tried to call. They took that a long time ago.
This is the most popular radio show ever.
Hey, we're probably getting some listeners out there, you guys, on this show. Who knows?
Where at?
Oh, for fuck's sake.
Well, there's 2 viewers on the Facebook live stream of it.
Jeremy, I can't believe you're Facebook live on that, dude.
3, 2,
oh, shit.
6,
don't be doing that.
It's not available. At the tone, please record your message.
Oh, damn, or now it's really popular.
He ain't answering me. I'm going to give it up.
Wow. Thank you, Jimmy. You just broke the fourth. 5th and 6th wall.
Oh, Lord, he did. He did. He put toe slipper on there.
Anybody feel free to call the number.
No, he did not put toe number up.
Yeah, I did.
Yeah, I did.
Oh, my God.
Feel free to call.
Feel free to call.
Yeah, bunch of complaints.
That's epic. That's another epic.
Don't want to fuck him so his wife can hear it.
Hey, you hate the show.
You guys know what?
No,
this has got to be the most professional radio show I have ever heard.
Look, it's not about professionalism.
It's about funniness, man.
It's about revenge.
Having
fun.
Yeah, it's about
that's what
revenge.
This show is really about, revenge.
Right, he's letting Les Kimo take over my broadcast.
Oh, keep it going.
And screwing up my software when I'm teaching how to record a show and send it to me.
Oh, all gosh. Right?
Joe doesn't get this. He'd rather give it out to somebody. Now,
hey,
what if Les hates me?
No. Shh.
What if Les hates me and Joe one
day? Let Jimmy keep talking.
And he decides to, I'm going to get back at him. I know the password to the broadcast, and I can fuck his whole show up. You know what I mean? That's what Joe's not getting.
Hey,
we got on this ship anyhow.
I have no problem. But not my broadcasting show.
Next week at this time slot, you will be hearing music.
Hey, when people get mad, if people get mad at you, Jimmy, you're right. That's the first thing they do. They try to get back at you. Oh, yeah. Like it's mad. They do. Some people are vengeful like that.
I think someone just touched his ass. Okay.
That one was an accident, guys. Sorry.
I'm telling you, man, that first co-host I had, he got mad at me, and he went around just lying and vindictive. Some people are vindictive.
Oh, wow.
Hell out there, brother.
And that, we don't say his name.
We won't say his name. I don't want to say
his
name.
It's like the Kennedy man. You don't say his name.
Yeah,
but, he who must not be named.
Like,
but,
like yeah. a serial murderer. You never should give out the serial like, murderer's
like
name.
That one
you
guy
give
from
publicity.
Harry Potter.
Well, I was going to name...
The white guy from Harry Potter? Wasn't every guy in Harry Potter white?
No, I said that one guy from Harry Potter.
Yeah, Voldemort. Voldemort.
I was going to say...
Oh, shit. Dave, you done named white. Me. We're all fucked.
Well, I was going to get a dog once. I was going to confuse it. I was going to name it Go. I was going to get a dog and name it Go. That way I'd say, stop, Go. Stop, Go. It would have been a very confused dog. Are we all fair?
No, producer's still on. We're good.
Jimmy
keep
and
going.
Him. Jimmy's still gone. I mean, Jimmy left and them. I think they got. They're back.
No, he's
Jimmy,
back. He's
we're back.
Time permitted for recording.
I was trying to do a sound check with Arena, but she's not answering.
Are you serious?
Worry about her show after this one.
What the hell's going on?
I don't know. Bring in the crickets, Jeremy.
I can't get to the goddamn place. My phone's still on, but I can't shut it off.
Hey, you really feel.
This is what I fucking deal with all the time.
You don't like your job, you don't strike. You just go in every day and do it really half-assed.
Alrighty.
Now that was a long one.
That was a long one.
Worth it. Worth it.
But it was at the appropriate time for once.
Man, you had to throw.
I am a horrible sound guy, but you know,
yeah, I had to throw
I
it
tried.
In for once. Yes.
You guys know if those phones would have been on, Les would have probably called us. Les would have probably called in tonight. We would have got some calls, you guys. I've got some friends listening tonight.
Oh,
I just wish those phones would have been on.
For everybody listening, we're sorry.
Yeah,
no, he's not.
It's officially become painful.
We haven't got any phone calls tonight.
No shit.
Did anybody try Donald? Try calling again.
I'll try calling again.
The answer machine, right?
It went right to the voice.
Yeah, the phone's so not on. We can't get.
He's doing this on purpose.
I want to cut
my
fucking head off.
Here I go. I'll call it again.
Who gives
I'm
a
I'm gonna
fuck?
Play it right on here, you guys. I'll tell you what I'm hearing. I'll let you know what I'm hearing.
Please say your name, then press pound.
See, there's where it goes, guys. Voicemail.
Yeah, but it says please say your name and then press pound. What the hell does that mean?
I don't know. You mean
say
try
your
it?
Name and press
yeah.
pound?
You should
say
that I'm Donald Wisman. Press pound.
All right, let me try it. Then.
Hey, Donald Wisman with all aboard Tuesday nights at 8:00.
Yeah.
Hang on. Here it goes. Here it goes.
You are a fucking whore.
Hang on, you guys. I'm doing
wow.
it.
Wow. Fucking shit.
Oh, there it goes. Oh,
there's
the
there's the call.
That's me.
Yeah.
Okay, so everybody, if you want to call in, just say your name and press
and it
pound.
Just killed you.
Oh, it didn't even come
to he hung up.
I hung it up. I hung it up. It was me.
Oh,
guys.
What the fuck, man?
We were going to have you on the show.
You was going to have me. I'm already on the show. But I just want everybody out there to know what we got 10 minutes left. If you do want to dial in 1-800-508-5431, press, say your name and press the pound key, and it'll put you right to Jimmy. So it did work, Jimmy. Thank you. It did
well,
work.
That, now nobody's going to call.
It doesn't matter. We only got a few minutes. Well, we got 9 minutes.
Yeah, put your phone away.
What are we, Donald, you got a new subject?
Who, me?
Yeah.
I could go on all kinds of things. I'm eating. I don't even. My wife just handed me some kind of, it's a frappe, something. I've never had one before. It's
the
caramel.
Hell is that?
Hey, if Irina doesn't come on, can we keep going?
Right, but I think she's here.
Oh, she is there.
Good.
Nice.
Hey, I'll tell you guys what, real quick. When you guys were little and you first ate McDonald's, it seemed like...
Yeah, she is.
Didn't McDonald's food used to taste a lot better than it does now? I mean, I know it's not fun.
Well, it does this, me.
Well, I ask a question, but thanks, Jeremy, for
that's
the...
That's Burger King.
No, I mean, every restaurant, it seems like they just put junk in our food anymore. It used to taste good, man. Now it tastes just like chemicals. I don't know.
Don't Monsanto, Donald.
GMOs.
Yes, HMOs.
There's a phone.
Did we get a call?
That's not me.
Oh, shit, we got a fucking call.
Oh, God, everybody's so shocked.
Hold on. He's going to fuck it up.
Got to hit one.
Hey, answer the phone, right, Papa?
Hello?
You're listening to All In. Dana,
where you from, bro?
I just called to say y'all doing a good job and keep it up.
Sounds
thank
good.
You,
where
brother.
You calling from?
Louisiana.
All right.
Yes, our Cajun friends what? Down south.
That's
yes.
That car, Dad.
Really?
They're doing good, man.
We call them crawfish up here. Crayfish. Same thing though. They are good.
We appreciate you listening to us. We're trying to fucking expand the audience.
Ask him if we're funny, Paul. Ask him if we're funny.
Do you think we're funny? Who's that? Your daughter?
No, do not let your daughter on the show. No. No, that's child abuse.
Does he
know?
I mean, does he
child abuse? Yeah, okay.
No.
No, it's great.
This will probably grow her up quick.
Well, I wish I could understand what y'all saying, because y'all keep breaking up. I can't understand y'all.
All right.
Must be the Boston accent.
No! I think he means what he's on the phone.
I think he's talking about you guys talking to him on the phone.
I know what he was talking about.
Okay.
I'm glad you called. Thanks for calling.
New York in and out, man.
That's why we gotta go.
Peace out, brother.
Bye.
Take care. Keep
bye,
listening.
Chris.
Tell your friends. That was nice. You cut him off right in the middle of a fucking sentence.
Jeremy, I just see you posted in social chat. What are you talking about there?
Somebody at Walmart apparently decided Dana wasn't handicapped enough.
Oh, I see it. I'm backed up now. I'm reading it now. I'm sorry. I didn't know what y'all was talking about. We got a social chat thing going on with you guys.
So if we need to, we'll go up and string them up.
How handicapped is
she? She'll just shoot.
Yeah, it's good.
Right.
They'll shoot him.
I think Dana can handle herself.
That's Dana's wife, you guys. Dana, that's his wife. She was in a coma for a long time, you guys. She had a bad time when she was in her, in her 20s, Dave?
Whoa. Your wife was in a coma?
Yeah, she was, 6 months.
Holy shit!
Yeah, I had a nephew for 3 months.
Oh, God bless her for coming back.
Yeah, I know. She got brain damage?
No.
She married
I don't know. She married me.
I have never seen that so perfectly
that
in my life. That was perfect.
I mean, I'll tell you something. I mean...
See, this
ain't damage.
This whole time I thought Joe might have been mad at us not giving us the phone, but it's just I guess it's just a new thing where you got to say your name and hit pound. It's kind of weird. It didn't do that last week.
No, it didn't.
It probably did. That's why we were missing everything.
Well, we
it
need to know
made
anything.
Me, it still Rob made
had
me
the same problem.
No, but it still made me hit one.
But it doesn't matter. Rob had the same problem.
No, I understand that, but we hit one, and this one actually answered.
But shouldn't we be able to tell people that what they got to do is say their name and hit the pound key from now on? I mean, since that's what they got to do.
I don't know. There's a lot of time you get the answering machine.
If we can get that out in between you plugging your fucking show and your shirt.
You're silly, man.
I mean, you know, we can't help it. Tuesday night's 8 o'clock all aboard.
You start with any key. All right. Where's the any key?
Listen to any of your show again. I keep forgetting.
I owe you guys one. Tuesday night's 8 o'clock. I owe you guys. So listen. Jeremy, I'm trying to plug a show that you're a guest on, okay? So everybody, on Thursday nights at 8 p.m. Eastern Time, listen to a show called Pot Talk on ARM Radio with Jimmy Bell, Paul Daniels, and guest starring Jeremy Gibbs.
Not guest starring! He's a
I'm a star? Holy shit!
Yeah. It should be Jeremy first, then me, then Jimmy.
Wait a minute, now, Jeremy, permanent co-host now, so can I say co-host? I don't know.
That's what I call it, J&P and J.
Yes.
J&P and J, Jeremy, Paul, and Jimmy.
That sounds like a bad job.
Yeah. That could be Jeremy or Jimmy, Paul, and Jeremy. I mean,
it don't matter to me.
Sounds like something you find on Pornhub.
J&P and J.
That sounds like something Jimmy's going to look up on Craigslist.
No, it sounds like something I'm going to eat peanut butter and jelly.
Yes. And if anybody's wondering what Pot Talk stands for, it's politically offensive talk. So there you go. I plug Pot Talk.
And I promise we will be offensive every week.
It's about time he plugged somebody's show other than his own.
Well, I'll tell you guys the truth. I will tell you guys the truth. I think Shannon did a good job on her first show.
I was going to say while we're at it, we should plug Shannon's show.
Yeah, plug it. Go ahead.
You guys cut me off guard. I forget the name. It's Talk Paranormal Live.
Talk Live Paranormal.
We know what he thinks of Shannon, I guess.
Wednesday night at 11 p.m. with Shannon Griffin. It's a good show. I thought she did really good on her first show, guys.
Yeah, and don't fuck with her. She's armed.
Is there a recording of that show, by the way?
Yes, go to Spreaker, or you can go any Dave's page, my page. I think we shared it, but Spreaker.com's got it.
I wasn't able to listen in on that one.
Jimmy's page. Jimmy got some on his page, too. Jimmy does.
What's that?
The shows. Don't you put the shows usually on your Facebook page?
We upload it pretty much.
Up on Spreaker, it usually takes me, I'll get it on my page, because I don't think I put last night's on my page.
And for everybody out there,
you had to see him last night.
If you go to Spreaker.com,
what are you going to do with your life?
Type in Jim Bell, and it'll come up, or Paul Daniels.
We should just do a show where we interrupt each other nonstop.
That's what we're doing here. I'm trying to tell everybody how to listen. Go back to listen to the replays on Spreaker.com.
All right, sorry.
Open it
everybody
up.
Everybody be quiet.
Type in either Jimmy Bell, that'll take you right to his show on Spreaker.
You're going to download Spreaker and then search for ARM Radio.
I didn't. I just go in there and type in Jim Bell, and your show came right up.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
And the same with Shannon. I just typed in Shannon's name. Her show came up. So.
Well, that's because I put in the show, and I go with Shannon or with Jimmy and Paul, with and Jeremy. You know what I mean?
You could probably type in Paul's name, and your show would come up, too.
Well, I put in hashtags. I usually put in about 5 or 6 hashtags.
No, you type in my name in the fucking sex registry.
It's
9 o'clock, guys. Do we got to get off here or what?
We gotta go.
See you folks next week.
All right, bye, everybody.
Donald, want to plug your show again?
No. I'm gonna make a video tomorrow. Do that.
Okay.
I'll tag you in it.